Hey, what's up everyone? Morey Croson here, and today we're gonna be talking about centrifugal force and why it's important. We'll start the video right now. This is the newest edition of the Performance Lab.
Reach your individual goals. You don't wanna just talk about straight line speed. We also wanna talk about your ability to be quick. We break down your video. Let's make you into the quarterback I know you can become.
All right, so I couldn't be more excited to talk about this topic just because I do think it's going to provide a ton of value for any of the quarterbacks that are watching here today to be able to understand how you can throw the ball with more force, more velocity, be able to, you know, really understand what are some of the physics behind throwing the football far and why it is that we really stress some important parts of your mechanics in order to make it so you could actually see improvements within your throw. So what is centrifugal force is what we're gonna start off with here. This is just like a Britannica website here. That goes a lot more in depth into all these different things, but I really wanna go and concentrate here at the bottom of what we're saying here. And I'm gonna start a little bit, about halfway through. I'm gonna go ahead and highlight everything that I'm gonna be talking about here. So we'll start at the top where it says, for example, when analyzing the behavior of the fluid in a cream separator or a centrifuge, it is convenient to study the fluid's behavior relative to the retaining container rather than relative to the earth. And in order that Newton's law be applicable in such a rotating frame of reference, an inertial force or fictitious force, which is the centrifugal force, equal and opposite to the centripetal force, must be included in the equations of motion. All right, so just getting a little bit into the backgrounds of what is a centrifugal force, just like the basic understanding of what it has to do with, you know, when there's a action happening and, you know, what is gonna be the, you know, anything that's like spinning, what's gonna be the middle, which is referring more towards the centripetal, and then, you know, obviously the centrifugal is what we're gonna be talking about. So in a frame of reference attached to the whirling stone, the stone is at rest. To attain a balanced force system, the outward acting centrifugal force must be included, right? So if you're going to be spinning a stone is the whole idea that they're talking about here. The outward action is really what we're talking about. Okay, so just want to get a baseline. This is really what's important here. Centrifugal force can be increased by increasing either the speed of rotation or the mass of the body, or by decreasing the radius, which is the distance of the body from the center of the curve. Increasing the mass or decreasing the radius increases the centrifugal force in direct or inverse proportion, respectively, but increasing the speed or rotation increases it in proportion to the square of the speed. That is an increase of speed of 10 times, say from 10 to 100 revolutions per minute. Increases the centrifugal force by a factor of 100. So what that means is when we're looking at somebody throwing, you could either increase the centrifugal force, right? Because this is gonna be what the centripetal force is like your body, how you're generating force through the body. And then the centrifugal force is gonna be, you know, the force that is getting active on the ball. Okay, so this is where the centrifugal force is, you know, how to be able to generate more overall force within the ball. Okay, that's what we're talking about here. Okay, and so the ways to be able to do it is one, increase speed, or two, decrease radius, right? Those were the two main things that they talked about. Okay, so what happens a lot of times when we're watching people throw, okay, that are not able to get as much distance? They're letting the ball get too far away from their body, right? They're getting to this position, okay? And then they continue to let the ball go further and further away. Okay, that's one. And the other thing is spending too much time with like the ball back behind the head, or not being able to, you know, properly get your arm to be able to come through because you're not generating very much torque. You know, you're not pulling within that front arm. So, you know, the speed of the arm isn't great. Okay, and so those two things are the main things to be able to help you out in being able to generate more force. So what do we see with Josh Allen, right? We see him loading here, you know, getting himself in a position where now he could pull back that back arm. You can see how fast he pulls that arm and is in this position to fire, right? We can make a comparison. This isn't as far of a throw that we're seeing on the left, but we're just gonna make a general comparison of, you know, once we initiate kind of that elbow firing. Right, so let's go like 4-3 here to about 6-1. Okay, so we had in comparison to 8-6, to 03. Okay, so we're just getting a general understanding of, you know, how fast, and it's probably a little bit late here, you know, because really at this point, you know, who knows where he's at. But we're probably at about, you know, to me, because this is going to be 0.17, and then this is going to be about 0.18, so it's not a huge difference, but we're a little bit slower. You could just tell from the, you know, frame rates, we're a little bit slower in our ability to really capture all this. So this one's probably a little bit closer to 0.15, maybe. Okay, and so regardless, you know, there's a big difference in the height, too, of these two people, right? We're talking about probably 6'7", and probably 5'10". Okay, and so there's an increase of speed, okay? And you can see that the ball is way further away from the head in comparison to way closer, right? The head or the elbow and the ball are right on top, right? Where elbow and ball, okay? And so, you know, you gotta be able to decrease how far the ball is from, you know, the rotating body, okay? And we got to increase the speed of the arm. That is how we can generate more force within the ball, just from a pure centrifugal force physics perspective, trying to help you guys out as many different ways as I can, trying to do as much different research as I possibly can. Here is another great example of how we could help you out by increasing your, and really improving your overall throwing mechanics. I'm super excited for the camp tomorrow. We're gonna be doing a camp, I guess when I post this, it'll probably be today. You know, gonna be able to really connect with a lot of guys and be able to help them throw the ball further, right? That's the goal of this camp here for the quarterbacks, being able to help you understand how to throw the ball further, right? And that was, I always say this, the biggest mistake I made when I was in high school, when I was in youth, not putting a big enough focus on distance in throwing. I had to be able to, you know, I was focused more on accuracy and timing and getting the ball out of my hands and making the right reads and not focused enough on adding velocity and adding distance to the throw, right? Those things are going to be what make you recruitable. That's just the fact of reality here, right? When you go to all these camps and showcases and things like that, they're looking for guys with strong arms. They're looking for guys with D1 arms. They're not looking for guys that can throw the ball on time. Their mentality as coaches, I'm just letting you know, is they want to teach you how to throw the ball on time, right? They believe they could teach somebody to throw the ball. So they look at it as a project, right? They're not looking at for the guy that's already able to do that, because they're saying, I can't teach somebody how to throw the ball further. I can teach somebody how to make the right read, how to throw the ball on time, blah, blah, blah. That's how a lot of Division I quarterback coaches think, right? And so you got to be able to connect with that. So you got to give them what the guys want, right? You can't give people or expect to get an offer from somebody when you're not giving them what they want. You got to give them what they want. They want velocity. They want throwing distance. Join the program. Find out more. We got a free Zoom. We got to sign up down below. There's just so many reasons to do this, with the breakdowns, with the Zooms, with the workouts, with the nutrition. I mean, I don't know how else to be able to help you guys and being able to really make the right decision to help you long term here. But I'm trying to do everything that I can. So as always, thanks for watching. If you like the information, click that thumbs up, subscribe to the channel. If you have any questions, comments, or recommendations, leave those down below. I'm saying that quick now. I'm getting pretty good with all this stuff. Yeah, man. I mean, come on. If you're still watching, check it out. Like, let's hop on a Zoom. There's a free Zoom. I have the link down below. Let's hop on a Zoom. Let's talk. Let's hang out. Let's figure out how to make it so you can be a better quarterback. You know, I know that joining the Throw 60 is going to be the best way for you guys to go. So leave a comment. Let me know what you think. Talk to you soon.